kicking off. Prince is receiving. Got Tony Malink will kick off for Muller. Tony Malink is loosening up on the field at this moment. He's going to do the kicking off for Muller. Both teams are entering the game. Muller has a 29-game winning streak. Last team to defeat Muller, of course, was Princeton, the year Princeton went to the state championship, 1978. Okay, we've got the receivers, both receivers back deep. Okay, we got David Gleaves. Tony Malink is ready. Approach the ball. The ball game is underway. Received on about the 10. Coming straight up the middle is a middle wedge. Nice hole. Breaks through. Looks like he's down at about the 32-yard line. Excellent return in there by David Gleaves. Very nice return.
Had a very good wedge in there, Howie. Almost broke out in the open.
Okay, offensive lineups in here. Tonight for Princeton, we've got Robbie Leach at center, right guard is Steve Phelps, right tackle is Mike DeLoach. They're over the ball, Darryl Mitchell, quarterback. Hands back, reverse pivot, back on the left side, straight ahead dive. Looks like it picked up yardage up all the way up to the 34-yard line. Remaining lineups at the split end for Princeton, we have Mike Lindsay, left tackle is Robert Jansen, left guard is Tim Canada. Tight end is Arnold Franklin. Good. Cornell Mullen splits wide. The tight end is flexed out. Got Veer backfield. Split backs. Darryl Mitchell throws a quick slant in pass in there. Overthrows him just slightly. Very nice tackle in there.
Princeton is alternating their flanker backs by sending in the plays with Farley and Mullen.
Okay, defensive lineup for Muller. They've got at the outside, wide side halfback is Mike Hartman. Rob Brown is the other defensive half, and safety is John Raines. The inside linebackers are Mike Harkmeyer and Mike Larkin. It comes down an option, a pitch coming around. They go swinging around the right end. Tackle in there. Charles Emery whipping around the ball all the way down to about the 45-yard line. It's a first down for Princeton, first one of the ball game.
This Princeton team is the fastest team that Muller has played all year. Muller is really going to have to hustle.
No question about that. We talked with Coach Faust before the game, and he's extremely worried about the speed that Princeton has. Princeton's out over the ball, split backfield. They split the tight end again. Arnold Franklin out to the left. Reverse pivot in there. Same type of play they ran to the far side, the very first play of the game. Stopped in there for no gain. It comes down to second and 10. We got 10 minutes and 40 seconds remaining in the game at this point. No score. Second and 10 on the 44-yard line.
Princeton has averaged 237 yards a game this season.
Formation left. We got two wide receivers, both split ends, both wide receivers out. It goes the option around the far side. David Keeling carrying the ball. Looks like he picked up about 5 yards. Should be coming up right now to about third and 5. 10 minutes remaining in the ball game, and we're still no scores. Ball brought back to midfield.
David Keeling has tremendous speed. He has over 1,000 yards just playing 6 games this year.
Mike Larkin giving the defensive signals out there. Got the replay coming around. You can see the speed of David Keeley as he carries that ball on the far side. Princeton breaking out of the huddle. They put two wide receivers to the right. We have third and 5. Big play. Comes down. Here comes the option again. Darryl keeps the ball this time. He's swarmed under and tackled by the 4 or 5 Muller players in there for no gain. Now it's 4th and 5. Kicking team comes on the field now. Paul Palumbo is a punter for the Princeton Vikings. Back to receive them. Paul Colombo back to punt the ball. Tim Cannon is a snapper. High kick going down. Looks like it's going to be caught on the 25. Spins back, falls down on the 25-yard line.
Real good coverage, Hal, on that punt team by the Princeton punt coverage team. They really got down here like a swarm of bees.
Yes, they certainly did. Rob Brown received that and then spun in there. I thought they did an excellent job. He had a hang time in here of only 2.85 seconds for Paul Palumbo on that punt.
It's important that the punter put that ball up in the air, Hal, so the coverage team can get down there and give him good coverage and not let the ball carrier get started.
Muller's out over the ball. They shift into their tight slot. I formation in the backfield. It looks like a mix-up in the play. Mike Wilging turns around. They swarmed under by a host of Princeton tacklers. Looks like a little mix-up in there. They shifted out to the tight slot to the left. Mike Wilging is having some trouble handing that last play off. All right, we're going back to second and nine now.
Sometimes it's awful hard to get that first play started, Hal.
Yes, you can see excellent pursuit around there. We're back to a second and a long 9 yards with 8 minutes to go. There's no score in this ball game. Straight T backfield. They shift into a wide slot. Francisco goes into the tailback position. Here comes the handing off in there to Mark Brooks. He picks up several yards. It was a fake pitch to the outside on a wide play to Francisco. He handed the ball off to Mark Brooks up the middle and picked up about 4 to 5 yards. It looks like it's third and a long 5 yards right on the 29.5-yard line. There's 7 minutes and 40 seconds to go with no score in this ball game.
Muller likes to feed that football to Mark Brooks. He's a tremendous runner. He only needs 79 yards in this game to reach 1,000 yards this season.
Right. Jeff Litton, the center, is over the ball. Mike Wilgan, quarterback. They shift into the tight slot to the left. As Tim King out on the slot, they pitch the ball back. Comes around. Francisco swarmed under in there. Excellent tackle in there by Reggie Dillingham, the defensive end. Muller's going to have to kick. There's a loss on that play. Ball's back. It's fourth and eight. The ball is on the 27-yard line of Muller. They're going to have to go back to punt now. Putting David Gleaves deep and Darryl Mitchell, the quarterback, the two deep players to receive this punt.
Now that Princeton defense has tremendous speed and great reaction.
Real high punt. It's a short kick. Hits down on about the 42, rolls forward. Muller players are letting it roll. It's going to go down and be down on about the 36-yard line. We had excellent hang time, got good roll. We had 4.1 hang time by the punter from Muller on that play.
That gives the coverage team a good chance to get down here and stop the ball carrier before he gets started, Hal.
All right, we'll give you the rest of those defensive starters. We've got Charles Lyme at defensive end. All right, Prince is over the ball. They got the wide slot. Comes back, fake pass. He dumps it to the side. He was trying to hit the tight end, Arnold Franklin. Princeton can't put both wide receivers to the wide side.
He faked a quick look into number 42 that time, Hal, and then tried to hit him on a takeoff and just overthrew the ball.
All right, the ball is on the 36-yard line. We've got second and 10. There's 6 minutes and 23 seconds to go in the first quarter. There's no score. Muller's lining up. They play an eight-man front, meaning that they have four down linemen. They have four linebackers and three defensive backs. This time Princeton comes out. They split their tight end. All right, hands back. There was a fake dive in there. Darryl Mitchell keeps the ball, goes up to the 40-yard line. Pick up about 4 yards on that. Now we come up. We're at third and five. Third and five on the 40-yard line. Very big play coming up at this point for Princeton with 6 minutes and 3 seconds to go in this first quarter and no score.
Darryl Mitchell has been a consistent ground gainer all year for him. How running that option, he's got a 5.1 average.
All right, again, Princeton comes out, putting both wide receivers to the left side. Comes down, they fake the option. There goes Darryl Mitchell. He's keeping the ball. He's turning. He's already got the first down. He's turning it up. Tremendous speed. He takes the ball all the way down to the Muller 47-yard line. It's Princeton's second first down of the ball game.
Mitchell's got great quickness, isn't that option? Is a real weapon for this Princeton football team. Mitchell gained 160 yards at the Arlington game.
All right,
game
here we come on the replay.
Year.
You see Mitchell carrying the ball. He's turned up the corner. He's keeping it to tremendous speed. All right, it's first and 10 in there. Princeton comes out with formation to their right side. They put the flanker back out to the right. Again, they have their split backs. He comes down, fakes it. Darryl Mitchell's dropping. He's going for the bomb. Throws it way over the head of the intended receiver down at that point.
There's real good pass protection in there, Hal. The quarterback had a lot of time to look over the pass defense and throw the football. There was nobody down the middle where he threw the ball.
Yes, he had Larry Farley streaking up the left side. He ran other wide receiver. Looked like Ron Durrett running down there, who was the intended receiver on that play.
Princeton has completed 40% of their passes this year. They've completed 24 out of 60 passes, Hal.
All right, again, it's second and 10. Both wide receivers out here. Comes down with the option play. There's Darryl Mitchell pitching it back. Charles Emery's thrown back there for a loss. Looks like about a 5 to 6 yard loss. Ball is down on about the 48-yard line.
Randy Barger had tremendous pursuit on that time. He just ran the ball carrier right into the sideline. Didn't have a chance to turn upfield at all.
There's Darryl Mitchell, reverse pivoting, coming back, pitching the ball back. Charles Emery coming down. Real big play for Muller at this point. It's third and 15 in here. Of course, we can look for anything. We haven't seen a screen pass. We haven't seen a draw. These could be the plays coming up as third and 15. All right, there's a quick screen out the left side. Throwing to Larry Farley, receives the ball. Takes the ball back just past the original line of scrimmage. Looks like we're going to have fourth down and about 8 yards to go. 4 minutes and 42 seconds to go in the ball game. There's still no score. Oh, it looks like we have a clip on Princeton. Charlie, sometimes that happens on that quick screen to the wide receiver out there. They threw that out there, and they ended up with the clip on that play.
Well, the linemen get out there, Hal, and sometimes the man that they intend to block turns at the last minute, and it turns out to be a clip.
Very crucial penalty for Princeton. Takes the ball all the way back to their own 35-yard line. We've got to go for a first down now. They've got to go all the way to the Muller 37. We've got about third and 29 now. David Keeling checks into the ball game.
This is a time, Hal, when a coach goes up to the press box and says, what have you got? And this is when they're looking for that big play, but it's kind of hard to make it on a situation like this. About the best you can hope for is maybe hit a short pass over the middle and run a little bit to get a little bit better field position to kick.
That's right. I think that was, of course, unfortunate for Princeton a moment ago when they tried that screen pass out there. They had the clipping penalty, and of course, that's what they were trying to do with third and 15. I think that it looks up to this point, Princeton has exhibited tremendous speed for a high school football team. They've broken a few real big plays, which have been good gainers. Overall, the Muller defense has been very strong in stopping the plays at this point. They've come up with a good defensive effort when they've had to do it.
Princeton is one of the fastest, quickest teams in the state. I heard Jerry Faust at the Boosters Club meeting the other night talking about the tremendous speed that this team had and the problem it was going to cause. How those penalties really cause you a lot of problems. Princeton this year has had 57 penalties for 509 yards, and that's a lot of yardage.
It certainly is. Of course, now we're okay, 4 minutes and 39 seconds after this timeout. We're starting up the ball. Okay, here goes Darryl Mitchell. He's back. He's being rushed. He throws short, just like he thought. He saw his receivers being covered deep. Muller had about three defensive backs that position. They have everybody covered, and he had to go short to the back in the flat. All right, Princeton has their punt team coming in. We've got a fourth and 29. The ball is on the Princeton 35-yard line. There's no score yet here in the first quarter. A very hard-fought game to this point. Princeton comes out. Punt formation. Got Paul Palumbo back. Tim Cannon just snapped that one. A good low kick going down the field. It bounces. Muller staying away from it. Princeton player downs the ball on the 35-yard line of Muller.
This is pretty good field position to start with, Hal.
Yes, it is. It certainly is. It was Reggie Dillingham that downed that punt for him right then. Muller takes over for only the second time in this quarter. So far in the ball game, Princeton has pretty well controlled the ball. Jeff Litton is out over the ball. There's Muller in a full house backfield. picks right up the middle. There goes Francisco breaking tackles, hitting a nice hole all the way up the middle. Carries in there for the first down by a few inches.
Hiawatha Francisco, he's going to be a real fine runner. He's only a sophomore, Hal. He's got tremendous speed. He's a 4-5 man in a 40.
See Mike Willigan handing the ball off. There he goes up the middle. Look, he breaks a couple tackles, has excellent blocking. Again, we got first down now, 46-yard line. Full house backfield for Muller. Hands in there, Mark Brooks. He's tackled hard, but he drives on his own power and picks up another 5 yards with his own power. They had him stop right about the line of scrimmage, but with that extra strength, he's an extremely big player, and he's strong and tough to bring down.
He uses that shoulder to explode into the tackler, Hal. Reminds me a lot of Jim Brown when he was playing with the Cleveland Browns.
Okay, Muller's up on the Princeton 49-yard line. Jeff Litton over the ball. Full house backfield. Mike Wilging pitches back. There goes Tim King around the right end. Upset over there. Looks like he picked up about 3 yards. We're going to come up to a very short yard situation right now. It looks like it's probably going to be around third and two at that point with the ball around the Princeton 46-yard line. And Tim King and Jeff Klaus alternate at the bring-in plays, alternate at the slot back. And they also play, of course, halfback in that full house backfield. Coach Jerry Faust's Crusaders. Jeff Litton over the ball again. Mike Wilging down, full house backfield. He looked to go to Brooks for this short yardage. Call it a play. Now he goes. There goes Jeff Klaus carrying. Looks like a power sweep off tackle. Looks like he's got the first down. All right, we've got another first down for Muller. They're moving the ball like that true machine that we know they are, Charlie. They've got tremendous strength and power in that offensive line.
They certainly do. Doug Williams is one of the finest offensive tackles in the state.
Jeff Litton over the ball. He's using a full house backfield. They shift into their slot, wide slot formation. Tim King and a short man. Hands it back in there to Francisco. Breaks directly up the middle. Carries it down for another 5 yard gain.
That offensive line is doing a fine job of blocking right now, Hal. They're opening up some pretty good holes in there.
There's Mike Wilging taking a snap from Jeff Litton. Reverse pivots, hang back. Mark Brooks throws a nice block. Hiawatha Francisco carries it off tackle and pick up a good 5 yards. A second and five on the Princeton 39-yard line. It's no score, full house backfield. Hands it into Mark Brooks. He's powering over people. Takes the ball down. Looks like another Muller first down. Carries the ball down to about the Princeton 28-yard line.
He not only has power, Hal, he's got a lot of speed and he's a very elusive back. The thing I like a lot about him a lot is he's a real fine blocker.
No question about it. That's an excent series off the, we've got the full house backfield. Jeff Litton out over the ball. Both sides of the line are really moving the ball. That was Lance Lohr and Jeff Cooper on that left side that last time. All right, they shift in, split the end out. Got a wing. It comes back on the inside, reverses. Tim King carrying over the right side. Got a trap play coming off that right side. They line up in the slot to our left. They split the, they had the action coming over to Princeton's right side and then handed back to that slot back off the right side for another nice gain.
Princeton is keen quite a bit on Brooks tonight. That's why they're using that play with the slot back coming back, Hal.
Right, that's the first time tonight so far. We're almost here at the end of the first quarter with only 1 minute and 21 seconds to go with no score yet. Still, there they go in that trips formation, which Muller refers to as jet right. That's a quick pitch. There goes Mark Brooks powering around the right side. There is a knock him out of bounds. He picks up about a good, gets the first down, picks up another 8 to 10 yards on his own. Had excellent blocking on that side. Muller lined up, made a quick shift, and pitched the ball back to Mark Brooks, and he takes it. They have some real power on that play.
Muller is starting to show some of the various formations they use, Hal. They give the defense an awful lot to look at. Shifting out of that regular T into the various formations is very tough on the defense.
No question about it. It's Jeff Litton coming out over the ball. Muller lining up in their straight T backfield. Here is first and 10. Ball's on about the Princeton 26. They shift into that same formation. That's trips to the right. It's three wide receivers out to the Muller. Here comes the four. Francisco back in motion to the left. They had some penalties. Looked like we might have had another back or somebody else moving on that play, Charlie.
Looked like quite a few people was moving on that play, Hal.
That's a real nice formation that, Muller has. They put those three wide, those three receivers out to their own right side, bringing that back in motion.
Usually the defense will overshift or put their strength where the three wide receivers are, and that's why Muller likes to come away from that.
Okay, officials for tonight. We've got Robert Welch, referee. We've got Paul Widener, Norm Wells, and Jack Shearing. See me doing an excellent job. It's a hard-fought game. We've got only 1 minute and 6 seconds to go. At this point, we've got first and 15 for Muller. Still no score in the ball game. Hands back to Francisco in there. Straight play up the middle. Looks like he had a fumble, and Preston has recovered. Big play for Prince at that point. Muller was driving and taking their ball down around their own 35-yard line and driven all the way down right the Princeton 28-yard line when they had that fumble, Charlie.
This is the way Princeton's been playing all year, Hal. They've been taking advantage of their opportunities. The defense will bend, but they very seldom break. They've done a tremendous job in stopping the opponent.
All right, split backfield again, formation to the right side. Hands back, here comes the option by Darryl Mitchell. He holds on to the ball, he's smothered by a host of Muller tacklers, led by the complete interior line. There was a fumble, looked like it was probably after the whistle, though. All right, we're over the ball again. Darryl Mitchell comes out, fakes that dive up the middle, keeps the ball in there. Swarmed under by a host of tacklers in there. Excellent defensive play by Muller. They've got tremendous, very well-coached defensive unit by Ted Bacigalupo, who's a defensive coordinator at Muller. Hands back again, there goes the inside play. Looks like we had David Keeling coming back over the middle, but it was very little gain on that. Very little gain. Looking down again at third down and 10 yards to go for Princeton. The ball is still in about the 27-yard line. It's the end of the first quarter of this. Yes, sir. There's still no score at this point in this ball game. Very hard-fought contest brought to you by Warner Amex Cable Television.
Now, you can bet that the Muller defense is going to key on David Keeling. He's a big playmaker. He's scored 12 touchdowns this year, and five of them have been over 40 yards.
No question about it, Charlie. That Muller team is, you know, they're an excellent defensive group. They're extremely well-coached. I think they've got, just as both teams are, we've seen two of the finest, undoubtedly finest football teams in the state of Ohio tonight. They're extremely well coached. A lot of former head coaches from other schools now on the staffs of each of these two schools. Ready to begin the second quarter in just a few moments. We still have no score at this point. We've got third and 10 for Princeton on their own. Ball is just shy by about 2 yards. Looks like it's about the 18-yard line. It's going to be third and a long 9 yards from the 18-yard line. Ball is almost in the middle of the field. Robbie Leach over the ball. Darryl Mitchell's coming in. He's been going on a quick count all night. Comes, he pitches the ball back. Oh, there's a fumble in there. Look, he fumbled the ball. It was almost picked up by a Muller player. And then, of course, David Keeling covered the fumble himself.
Ball bounced back right to him, Hal.
Yeah, that was Randy Barger is the one who had the ball. It was their outside linebacker. It was on the short side of the field. Muller refers to him as their closed linebacker. He always goes to the short side of the field. Both teams flip-flop their defenses, putting a few players to the wide side of the field, which they refer to as open, and the other players to the short side of the field, which they refer to as closed. Randy Barger almost had it, but it got away from, was recovered by the running back for Princeton, David Keeling. Here goes the ball. Paul Palumbo, it's a short kick going low. Comes fumbling the ball. Excellent return, excellent blocking by the Muller group right at that point. Very low kick. Wasn't a very good kick at that point for Princeton.
How usually when you start going backwards like that, you're going to lose yardage on the punt return, but that boy had enough speed that he got around a corner and picked up a couple of yards.
Yes, that was Rob Brown, and of course he did a good job. He just bobbled the ball momentarily. Muller's got excellent field position. They've gained over the last quarter with us. Full house backfield on the Princeton 46-yard line. Hands in there to Mark Brooks, who powers off the right side, picking up about 4 yards. We're going to have a second and about six from the 42-yard line of Princeton. Muller is just showing their brute strength at this point with 10 minutes and 41 seconds to go in the second quarter. Still no score in this ball game. Jeff Litton over the ball. Full house backfield by Muller. Mike Wilging comes back, fakes the handoff. Driving the ball, Mike Wilging, excellent pass down there. Complete. Complete to Ron Lindhorst. It was everybody play action on that play. We had only one wide receiver going out for it.
Now, that was a corner pass. The receiver went downfield about 10 yards and broke for the corner. The pass was right on the money. The receiver concentrated on it.
There you go. You can see the fake as Mike Wilging comes back, throws the pass. Beautiful play right there. Excellent throw by Mike Wilging, who's only a junior.
Great concentration on a receiver and catching that ball.
Jeff Litton over the ball. Full house backfield for Muller. First and 10. On about the Princeton 12-yard line. Wide slot to the left. Here comes motion coming back. Oh, we had offsides. I think we had encroachment by Princeton. I believe when that man started motion, who was Hiawatha Francisco coming back in motion, I believe one of the Princeton players went across the line. No, he wouldn't. We had somebody moved. It's the rules. I thought we had encroachment, what I saw here, but apparently someone from the Muller team moved before the play started. Big break for Princeton at that point. We've got a first and 15. First and 15 for Muller. They've got the short hash to the Princeton right side of their defense. It's going on wide side of the field is to the Muller right. The ball is first and 15 now on the Princeton 15. They go trips into the short side of the field. They have the three wide receivers. The ball goes back to Brooks, powers up the middle. Looks like he's picked up the 5 yards and back up almost to the original line of scrimmage. It should be second and 10 at this point for Princeton. Right, second and 10 on the Princeton 10-yard line. 10 minutes and 4 seconds to go in the second quarter. There's still no score, but Muller is threatening.
Mark Brooks is sure the workhorse for this Muller team, Hal. They're going to give him the ball 3 out of 4 times.
Muller full house backfield again. Mike Wilging. Muller shifts in. They put the wide slot to the right. They split the tight end to the left side. Wilging comes back. Hands off to Francisco on a tailback draw. He was coming back, faking like he's going to pass, then handed off to Francisco. Took about a yard on the play. It's going to be third and about a long 8.5 to 9 yards at this point. The ball looks like it's on the on the Princeton 8-yard line. They're third and 8. Big play at this point. Muller doesn't get this. They may opt to kick the field goal on fourth down. Full house backfield. Muller shifts, puts the three eligible receivers over the short side of the field. Wilging comes back. Brooks is blocking the backfield. Pops the ball on a drag pattern back across. He's in for the score. In for the score. As Rod Lindhorst had caught the ball, the receiver caught the same pass. Looked like a drag pattern coming back across. They had the fake action to the right. And they threw back to the left side. As Wilging taking a snap from Jeff Litton coming back. Mark Brooks blocking. Excellent line protection in there. Passing to Rod Lindhorst. Takes the ball in for the touchdown.
He knew where the goal line was, Hal. After he caught that ball, he pivoted around and hit it for that strike.
So Muller scores first in this game with 8 minutes and 59 seconds to go in the second quarter. Score is now 6-0. You know, I had the same type of situation just had a moment ago. Either Princeton jumped off an encroachment, which we couldn't see, or was consulting with the Muller captain, so he may have had a little. Yes, we had encroachment by Princeton. In high school rules, if anybody breaks the plane of the ball, different from college rules, if anyone breaks the plane of the ball, the play does not begin. It automatically is a 5-yard penalty. Known as encroachment. It's a new rule this year in high school ball. All right, we've got 6-0 score at this point. Muller is going for the points after touchdown. 6-0, 8 minutes and 59 seconds to go. 6-0 in favor of Muller.
Muller mixed in the pass real well with the running game, and that drive, Hal, was very effective.
No question about it. Ron Lindhorst, the man who just scored a touchdown. Tony Malink coming in, picks the extra point. Score is now Muller 7, Princeton nothing.
We have Aaron Mack. Mackey in the booth with us. Aaron, what do you think of the ball game tonight?
Well, of course, right now I'm very disappointed after that Moeller touchdown. But first, I'd like to say very quickly that I'd like to thank Warner Amex for doing the telecast tonight, and we're very proud of that.
Well, thank you, Aaron. It's real nice to have you with us in the booth.
Very disappointed with that score, though. And both these teams are second-half teams, and I think that if Princeton can get on the board, we'll be in good shape.
Well, it's early in the game, Aaron, and Princeton does have a real quick team.
Right.
Thank you for being with us.
Okay, thank you for having me.
Okay. Muller is lining up to kick off again. Ball's on the 40-yard line. Tony Malink, who just kicked the extra point, is, of course, lining the ball up to kick off. Princeton is lining up in a 5-4-2 formation. That means with five players blocking just between their own 45 and 50-yard line. David Gleaves is back. He received the last kick. Ball going down. Gleaves taking it again on about his own 8-yard line. They're forming a nice wedge, bringing the ball up. Tackle made on the 22-yard line.
David started to dance a little bit there, Hal. When you get that ball on the kickoff, there's only one way to go, and that's straight ahead and try to get behind that wedge and get as much yardage as you can and then maybe pop for daylight.
That's right. We had Ted Richter getting down underneath that and making the initial tackle on that play. Excellent play by Ted. Okay, first down on the 23-yard line. The score is Muller 7, Princeton nothing. Princeton puts two wide receivers out. To the far side, here comes Mitchell down the option. He opts to keep it again. Picks up 2-3 yards. Looks like he's got the ball almost up to the 25 to 26-yard line. Officials placing on the 25. We've got 2nd and 7. Larry Farley bringing the play in from Coach Pat Mancuso. Princeton out over the ball, Robbie Leach. Robbie Leach coming back, hands off to the inside. There goes David Keeling breaking in the open. Good play, bring him down. Brings the ball all the way down to the Princeton 48-yard line. Fantastic run by David Keeling.
Now that was a straight handoff, and he broke for daylight.
Okay, we've got Darryl Mitchell takes the ball, hands it off in there. David Keeling whips off the right side, breaks to the outside again in pursuit. Excellent pursuit going over there by Randy Barger, who was in on that last tackle, too. Two wide receivers out. There they go back up the middle. Another big play, almost for the first down. We're going to end up with a 2nd and 1, or we're going to be right there, almost the first down, with only inches to go for a first down. Another fine play, whipping up tremendous speed by this Princeton team. They're truly a big play team. It's 2nd and 1. The ball is on the Muller 44-yard line. We've got Muller leading in this contest, 7-0. There's 7 minutes and 22 seconds remaining. Ball is just to the right of midfield in the Muller half of the field. Split backfield again. Darryl Mitchell taking the ball from Robbie Leach. Comes back. Play action. Throwing the ball deep down the field. Almost intercepted in there. Almost excellent play at that point by Rob Brown, the defensive halfback. Excellent play.
Rob Brown is one of the best defensive halfbacks in the area, Hal. He's 5'11", 161-pound junior, and already this season he has 5 interceptions.
There is Darryl Mitchell coming back. Throws a long pass down there. Look at this play with a defensive back. Excellent. Almost had it. Two wide receivers out to the right side again. Oh. And looks like we had early movement, probably something of that nature. Or a third, a short yard, and early movement by the Princeton team at that point. Big play now. 7 minutes and 3 seconds to go. Had the penalty in there. Oh, he's got about 3rd and 6. The ball is on the Muller 49-yard line. Pro formation. Coming back, here comes Mitchell. He's being swarmed under the backfield. Throwing him for a loss. Loss of about 4 yards on that play.
Hey, there was tremendous pursuit by the Muller linebackers that time. They followed him right out to the sideline. He had no place to break. You know how on that previous drive there, that penalty really hurt Princeton. Princeton so far has had.
Okay, here comes Darryl Mitchell coming down to the option play on that. Excellent. The big thing that came through, as everybody could see on that replay, we had Bob Mayo, a defensive tackle, shooting through between the guard and tackle in there, making a play. Paul Palumbo is back to punt now. Got fourth and 10. It's a high snap in there. Low kick, short kick. Being taken by Rob Brown again. He breaks the outside. Muller's got a wall on the far side of the field. Very good return by the Muller team. They're going to have reasonable field position. The ball's going to be about on the Muller 37-yard line, first and 10, as they take over at this point. There's 6 minutes and 12 seconds to go. This is a hard-fought game, just like we thought, Charlie. There's no question about it. This is a series dating back for a number of years, all the way back to 1965. Muller's over the ball with their full house backfield. Mike Wilging down, calling a cadence. Comes back. Hands off. They had cross-bucking action in there. Halfback like Tim King was carrying that ball. They faked Mark Brooks off to the left side, a hand back to Tim King there, and he picked up about 7 yards. So we get second and 3 to go. Mike Wilging comes back, hands to Tim King, breaks through.
That's a good play because they're keying off of the fullback.
Okay, we got second and 3 right now. Here comes the pitch back to Tim King again, carrying around the right side in there. And Farley making the tackle, the initial hit in there at this point. Looks like Muller picked up about 3 yards, may be almost enough for that first down.
Timmy King's got some pretty good moves coming around here, Hal. You see that hip action? He's got a 4.9 average in running the ball this season.
Yes, he looked very good on that. He's carried the ball several times, and he's doing an excellent job. We got third and about a foot at this point with the ball on the Muller 46-yard line on the right hash. The wide side of the field beat a Muller's left. Princeton down there, 5-2-4 alignment. Princeton runs that, they're overshifted, the nose guard. It's moving into the right gap in there. There goes Mark Brooks, bread and butter man, carrying the ball, diving all the way up to about the Princeton 45. More than enough for the first down. Brooks picked up about 5 to 6 yards. This has been a very hard-fought half. There's only 4 minutes and 59 seconds to go in the second quarter. The score is Muller 7, Princeton nothing. Got first down, first and 10 to go. Jeff Litton over the ball at this point. Full house backfield by Muller. They shift in the slot. Oh, Francisco seems a little confused. Steps back into the eye backfield. Hands it off to Brooks. At that point, Brooks finds Kobe, fumbles the ball. May have been recovered by Princeton at this point. Yes, Princeton recovered Mark Brooks' fumble on its own 40-yard line. Princeton will be taking over. During the halftime festivities, the Princeton-Muller High School bands will entertain you with their musical selections. The Princeton band, consisting of 192 members, will thrill listeners with Shake Your Groove Thing, Enough is Enough, I'll Never Love This Way Again, and Soul Man. There will also be a routine by the Princeton Baton and Flag team. Stay with us at halftime for those outstanding events. Princeton out over the ball again. Two wide receivers coming back in there. Hands off to David Keeling again. Whips off another first down. Gain about 10 to 11 yards, taking the ball just across midfield into the Muller territory. Should be first and 10 on about the Muller 49.5-yard line.
How those fumbles really have hurt Muller. They fumbled 15 times this year and lost 8 of them.
Right. There goes Darryl Mitchell handing back to David Keeling again. Breaks off to the outside. There's Mike Larkin, the outstanding linebacker, of course, making that hit back there at that point. Larkin's one of the best linebackers in the state, according to coaching staff. He's certainly showing that to us tonight.
Oh, there's a fumble.
There's a fumble in there. Mitchell got the ball. I don't know if they got the first down at that point. We'll have to see how the officials place it. Princeton had gotten the first down, then fumbled the ball, and then recovered. So the ball is placed down now. Fortunately for Princeton, of course, they recovered that fumble. So now it's third and 1 at this point. Third and 1. There are only 3 minutes and 36 seconds to go in this game with Muller leading in the contest, 7-0. Split backfield. Darryl Mitchell under the ball. Comes back. Hands off in there. Halfback straight up the middle. Looks like he's going to be very close to whether he got that first down or not. We're going to have to call a timeout and measure it. There's David Keeling trying to carry over the center of the line to get that first down.
Timeout for
Timeout for a measurement. This is certainly like all the other contests that Mueller and Princeton have had, Charlie. Since 1965, there have only been seven times that there have been more than a two-touchdown difference in the game. That is two touchdowns that Mueller has won the game by. And, of course, or Princeton has won the game. And only on two of those actually, since 1965, Charlie, only been two games that have been, you know, sort of three or four touchdowns. Every other game's been scored by just a few points or one touchdown, two touchdowns. This is a very tightly contested game each year.
It's been a great series, Hal, and in a game like this, anything can happen, and anything usually does happen.
Darryl Mitchell coming back with the option play again. He's got David Keeling trained. Mitchell elects to keep the ball, picks up about 1 yard. Spotting the ball back there. Gonna have second and nine. It's not a whole lot of time left. There's only 2:43 to go in the second quarter. 2:43 before halftime, with Mueller leading by a score of 7-0. Princeton puts two wide receivers to the wide side of the field. Leach over the ball, snaps it back to Mitchell, hands back straight ahead on the dive play. David Keeling goes through, picks up straight up the middle, picks up a couple of yards. Looks like it's going to be about 3rd and 5. And we've got Mueller getting ready to set up their defense. It's 3rd and 5. Officials are calling official timeout at this point. Got timeout right now in this game brought to you on television by Warner Amex Cable Television.
Princeton has been running that straight handoff with David Keeling quite a few times, and he's already broken two long gains on there. It's the type of play that he can run for daylight and score on. He's done a real fine job with that play all season long.
Yes, he has. He's had the best success when he started up the middle and broken to the outside. Those were his gainers. Mueller has stopped him when he stayed directly up the middle, but those plays when he's bounced to the outside after he started up the middle. They're coming ready, Arnold Franklin, the real outstanding junior tight end who's also an inside linebacker. For Princeton called timeout on that play as they were leaving the huddle.
Hal, this is the first game that David Keeling has played in 3 weeks, so he really doesn't have his timing back. He's missed all that action with a shoulder injury. He's a tremendous football player.
Yes, he certainly is. I was talking to Ed Hartwig, the trainer here for Princeton, before the game about David's situation. He told me he's ready to go. For a lot of people's interest, they might know that Princeton is the only school in this part of the state that has a credit class here at Princeton High School for athletic training purposes. In other words, they're training trainers for the future. In fact, Charlie, the full-time trainer over at the Green Hills Forest Park School District for their high school team over there is a trainer who came through Ed Hartwig's program right here at Princeton High School. Don't forget to stick around for the halftime activities when the Princeton and Mueller High School bands will perform for your enjoyment. Mueller will strike up the beat with the tunes El Dorado, Mississippi Mud, the old favorite Sweet Georgia Brown, and the Mueller fight song. The newly formed drill team from Mount Notre Dame High School will also be on hand. We hope you'll join us at halftime. It's only 2:01 to go in this contest. Pat Mancuso leaves his team on the field. Mueller is leading 7-0. We've got 3rd and 5 yards to go for the first down. Mitchell barking signals over the ball for Princeton. Comes back. They throw the inside slant. Almost picked off by Barger right there. Almost had the interception. He had a clear sailing in there. No question about it. If Randy Barger had picked that ball off, Charlie, he'd probably gone all the way.
He threw the ball a little bit behind a receiver and didn't have a chance to catch the football.
Okay, we got 4th and 5 at this point. Paul Palumbo's back to kick. Tim Canada, who's a starting guard for the Princeton team, goes over to snap punts on the punt team. Princeton uses the usual pro formation for punts. That puts two slot backs. High snap by Tim Canada over the head of Paul Palumbo. Comes back. He's trying to run the ball. Princeton knocks him out of bounds, stopping the clock at the Princeton, but the Princeton 34-35-yard line. Excellent play. It was a high snap in there. Unfortunately, went over the punter's head, tried to run the ball. He didn't have much else he could do at that point. Excellent coverage in there. Mike Lane, one of the people on the... There goes the kick coming back. Paul Palumbo's trying to pick it up, running to his left side, coming in there. Excellent coverage by that Mueller team. Mueller takes over on their own 35-yard line. They're coming out, full house backfield. They shift into that wide slot formation. Tim King shifting out of the backfield. Mike Wilgen comes back, hands it off to Francisco.
Francisco's got a lot of moves. He's going to be a real fine ball carrier in the future.
Yes, that was a good tackle by Ken Lawson, the inside linebacker for Princeton coming back. That Princeton has two outstanding linebackers in senior Ken Lawson and junior Arnold Franklin. Again, wide slot to the left by Princeton, second and 10. Coming back, we have a penalty on the throw. Wilgen comes back in there. Got an early flag on that play.
Real good pressure on a quarterback on that play by Reggie Schooler, number 99. By the way, his brother played here 2 years ago on a championship team, and his number was also 99.
Yes, in fact, that was the last time that Princeton beat Muller, and it was also the last time that Muller beat any, Muller has lost a game was in the 1978 season when Princeton went undefeated and, of course, went on and took the state championship.
Muller had a 37-game winning streak going at that time and had three straight state championships. And Princeton won the ball game in the last 7 seconds with a field goal.
Right, that was a Princeton had 13, beat Muller 13-12 at that point. All right, we're just almost the closing seconds of the first half. Mike Wilgen goes back to throw. He's thrown exceptionally good passes so far. Oh, looks like it might have been intercepted by Arnold Franklin down there. Try to throw a short curling pattern over the middle. Arnold Franklin, outstanding inside linebacker, intercepts the ball. There's Mike Wilgen going back, throwing a curl pattern over the middle. Excellent pass, but just throwing it in there. Arnold Franklin does an exceptionally good job stepping in there and catching the ball. They're coming back, looks like a halfback pass. He's in the open. Just a little bit overthrown. That's David Keeling coming back. They fake the option, pitch the ball back with the halfback pass.
It's a real good play at this time. It just overthrew the ball.
Yes, he's trying to hit Michael Lindsay on just a streak pattern. Okay, we got a replay on Wilgen game where Arnold Franklin steps in there. He's trying to hit Dan Staub, who's the son of the University of Cincinnati coach. Dan's a real fine tight end for the Muller Crusaders. And Arnold Franklin did an exceptionally good job stepping in front of Staub to catch the ball and make the interception for Muller. Second and 10 for Princeton. Hands back in. There goes Keeling breaking to the outside. Just as I mentioned to you, looks like he may go all the way. There goes Keeling at the left side. Arnold Franklin stay in front of him. He can keep going. It's Arnold Franklin. There he goes. He goes all the way. David Keeling goes all the way for a score. The score is now Muller 7, Princeton 6. Charlie, just like we were saying earlier, when Keeling breaks to the outside, he hits the open daylight, and then he cut back to the left side. Fantastic run.
Now, he did a tremendous job of using his blockers there, and his blockers got downfield, did a good job for him.
Here we see the replay on this. We see Darryl Mitchell, Robbie Leach down over the ball. Mitchell takes the ball, hands back to David Keeling. He bounces to the outside. That's where he's been having his success on this play. Then, like you say, Charlie, he's using his blockers, cuts back against Mike Larkin there. They're a real outstanding inside linebacker. That's a foot race. Look at the speed Arnold Franklin has shows in this play, getting down the field. Then at the last moment, Franklin does a very good block to cut down the last possible play. All right, we got the extra point kick, and the ball game is tied up with only 30 seconds to go in the second half. Excuse me, the second quarter. There's only 30 seconds to play. The score is now Princeton 7, Muller 7. Excellent run by David Keeling. That's the way Princeton has been, just like Pat Mancuso described it to us, Charlie.
David Keeling is one of the finest running backs in the state, Hal. In only six ball games, he's gained over 1,000 yards this year, and I think you can see on this
here
particular
play
why. Here
we get the Keeling bouncing to the outside again as we see this run down. Replay of the long run coming across.
Did a good job of reversing his field here, breaking the tackle. Now he turns on the speed. He's got 4-5 speed. It's pretty hard to catch him.
Another thing we might mention, but that was another key block to help him break that was thrown by Robbie Leach, number 57, as you saw in that replay. He's the starting center, of course, and co-captain for the Princeton Vikings. Outstanding student who wants to, Robbie Leach wants to go to one of the service academies. Very excellent student, one of the best on the Princeton Viking team.
How Arnold Franklin, who got down there and did such a good job of leading that play, is one of the top athletes on the field, and he's only a junior. If he were a senior, he'd be one of the most highly sought-after athletes in the state. He's a tremendous football player.
All right, Princeton is getting ready to kick off. Steve Fleming's the kicker on the Princeton team. They put the ball in the right, their own right hash. They're probably going to try to either kick to one corner or the other. Steve Fleming, one of the players they told me, Coach Jan Nepshield is the special teams coach here at Princeton. He mentioned Steve Harvey as somebody, number 44, who covers extremely well in these kickoff coverage. They kick the ball low, not wanting Muller to get a good run back. Breaking the ball, but pretty good run back. And there's Jeff Klaus bringing the ball. Looks like number 31, Jeff Klaus bringing the ball all the way back to the Muller 35. That was an excellent return. Muller used some cross blocking and a good wedge.
I think Jeff Klaus put his head down in there and just drove and got as much as he could have. Great attitude on that Muller team.
Yes, Muller's been there before. They've had a lot of close games. They've had two other close ones this year, both with Centerville High School and, of course, Elder here in Cincinnati. Muller's got the slot formation. Wilging back to throw again. It's hit up in the air. Looks like it's intercepted. It's a tip ball. Tip ball. Princeton's got the ball. Looks like right now Muller was trying to get back and go ahead in the game. There's a tip ball.
Oh, that was Reggie.
Ball's going to be about on the 34-yard line.
Oh, that was Reggie Dillingham, and intercepted that ball. That's his second interception this year.
That's Mike Wilgie. Three-step drop, quick pass, hit up in the air. Excellent athletic ability by that young man as he catches the ball.
As we said earlier, Hal, when these two teams get together on a football team, you never know what's going to happen. A lot of explosions out there.
No question about it. This is really just one of the most outstanding high school series in not only the state of Ohio, but I'm sure in many states. It's one of the best in the country. It's hard fought. There are never very many penalties. Excellent sportsmanship on both sides. Excellent leadership exhibited here by both coaching staffs, the student body, the fans of both teams. This is what high school sports are all about.
Hal, we're so fortunate here in Cincinnati. You know, they play outstanding high school football in the state of Ohio, and here in Cincinnati, we have two of the top teams in the state right here in River City.
That's right. Both these teams, for those who perhaps are not quite as familiar, Muller is currently ranked number one in the state. Princeton's ranked number two. Princeton's over the ball. Dropping back, there's Darryl Mitchell. They're going for broke. It's up the middle. He just overthrows the wire. We have pass interference. Official threw the flag down there. Looked like a post pattern. Mitchell was going for the bomb, trying to go all the way on that particular play.
Hal, this is the kind of football I like to see. This is wide open football. This is real fine high school football. These are two of the top high school coaches in the whole country, and these are two of the top football teams.
Yes, he was trying to hit Michael Lindsay on that on a quick post pattern, meaning the receiver goes straight down, cuts a little bit towards the goal post. We had some interference over there by Rob Brown, the real fine halfback, just made a mistake over there. Princeton, of course, with only 9 seconds to go, looks like they're checking in to kick the attempt the field goal, perhaps at this point. They're only 9 seconds. The score is tied 7-7. Princeton's lining up his field goal. Officials calling some time out right there, getting things situated.
The Princeton place kicker, Mark Starnes, is one of the top kickers in the area, Hal.
Right there. Muller looks like they're putting on the pressure. Jeff Raines, their safety, staying back. There goes the kick. Looks like it's a little short. A little short, just off to the side. Missed by just a few yards. Very good attempt at this point. There are 3 seconds to go on the clock. Muller will probably either, at this point, try to run the ball out. So just run out the clock on this last play. Either got to run. They don't have much choice, Miss Charlie. Either got to go ahead and run the clock, get in, regroup at halftime, find out what they can do against Princeton, or they can go for broke on this play with either, of course, a screen pass or just come back and throw the bomb. I'm extremely impressed with this Mike Wilging, the junior quarterback from Muller.
He's done a good job of reading the defense, and one thing about this Princeton team, they're not going to hold back. They're going to throw that football when they get the opportunity.
All right, hands off in there. Oh, there's Mark Brooks, almost breaking. Picks up the first down, takes the ball all the way down to the 36-yard line as the half ends. With the score at this point, Muller 7, Princeton 7, in this game brought to you by Warner Amex Coverage. We'll be right back with our halftime show right after this timeout.
Princeton High School is located in the Cincinnati suburb of Sharonville. Princeton serves the communities of Evendale, Glendale, Woodlawn, Springdale, Sharonville, and Lincoln Heights. The school district also encompasses parts of Sycamore and Springfield townships and unincorporated areas of Butler and Warren counties. Excellence is the word that describes the Princeton School District. Princeton High School has consistently lived up to high standards of excellence in academics and athletics. The school has gained widespread acclaim in its extensive offerings in curriculum and special programs. The courage to meet the challenge of the future is ever present. Each day is looked upon with an attitude of creativity and responsibility. A belief in the dignity and worth of all individuals is paramount at Princeton. The success of each student is the prime concern. In the words of Dr. Richard DeNoyer, superintendent of schools, we invite all residents and those interested in moving into the Princeton School District to visit our schools. Upon seeing firsthand the facilities and programs available for students and residents, and upon talking with our staff, the excellence of education opportunity becomes apparent. Muller High School was founded in the fall of 1958 under a directive issued by Archbishop Carl J. Alter. The school, which opened its doors in September of 1960, was named in honor of Cincinnati Archbishop Henry Muller, who guided the Archdiocese of Cincinnati through the first quarter of the 20th century. Muller High School takes pride in its tradition of helping each student to develop his total personality. Emphasis is placed on spiritual, intellectual, moral, and physical development. Muller students learn about their roles in modern society under the guidance of the Fathers and Brothers of the Society of Mary, diocesan priests, and dedicated lay teachers within the Archdiocese. Under the school colors of blue and gold, the Crusader sports teams have a winning tradition, and Muller students have consistently met high standards of learning. The school's curriculum places a strong emphasis on religion, mathematics, and the sciences, and Muller students measure up as winners, both on the athletic field and in the classroom.
The Men's World Fast Pitch Softball Championships on Sports America, Sunday night at 7. See the battle for the best and the fastest from 40 softball teams from the United States and Canada. Fast Pitch Softball, Sunday night at 7.
Watch it, TV 48.
Saturday afternoon at 3 o'clock, Chicago movie critics Roger Ebert and Gene Siskel review The Awakening, The First Deadly Sin, One Trick Pony, and The Stuntman. Sneak previews, The Consumer's Guide to the Movies. This week, Saturday afternoon at 3 o'clock. Watch it. Watch it on TV 48. This is WCET, Channel 48, Cincinnati.
Watch it, TV 48.
Thank you. such an important game.
Thank you.
back to Viking Stadium, where the score at halftime is 7-7. We're just about ready for the kickoff of the second half of tonight's game, and we hope you're enjoying this coverage by Warner Amex Cable Television.
Hal, this has been a tremendous first half. Both teams are playing outstanding defensive football. The thing that has hurt the Princeton team so far is that they've have had two penalties to stop their drives, and Moeller has had four turnovers to stop their drives.
Okay, at this point, we're seeing a replay of the big play where Darryl Mitchell handing off to David Keeling, who breaks, slips to the outside. One of the key blocks we'll see coming in here is Rob Leach, who blocks Mike Larkin, number 56, their outstanding linebacker. Here comes a key block right at this point. Rob Leach blocks out Larkin and then breaks to the outside, going down to the left sideline. Just an outstanding run. This, of course, enabled David Keeling to finish with 117 yards in the first half. Arnold Franklin going along with him, number 42. Arnold's going to throw a final block right at this point to make sure that nobody catches David as he goes all the way in the closing minutes of the second quarter for Princeton to score their first 6 points, their only touchdown so far. Remember, Charlie, of course, this is the first time somebody scored in about three games off Muller, too. Arnold Franklin throwing the final block. Of course, David Keeling going into the score. Princeton went on, kicked the extra point to tie the score at 7-7.
How, when David Keeling gets past the line of scrimmage, it's like trying to tackle a feather in a windstorm. He's really elusive. He's got good moves, quicks, and on that particular play, he had a lot of support downfield.
Boy, he certainly did. I tell you, we've had several outstanding runners. You might want to mention the statistics on Mark Brooks, the top fullback for Muller at this point.
Mark Brooks only needs 7 more yards to have gained 1,000 yards so far this year. He's done a real fine job. He's a bull of a fullback. He's elusive. He gets through that line. He makes real fine cuts. He's carried the ball for 10 times for 72 yards. David Keeling has carried the ball 9 times for 117 yards. He has been the big playmaker all year long for Princeton. It's just too bad that he missed 2 ball games for him earlier in the season.
No question about it. This goes down to the hard play. Muller line play line, of course, they're being coached. Muller has 2 offensive line coaches, Jim Higgins and Pat Orloff, 2 longtime high school coaches in this area. And the Muller line is doing a good job. There, Brooks is, you know, having some good protection by, of course, you mentioned earlier, Doug Williams being an outstanding tackle on that right side. Of course, Tim Odom also. Brooks has gained yardage behind them. And of course, Marks gained a lot of yardage on his own, but he's also run behind Jeff Cooper and Lance Lohr on the left side to pick up additional yardage for Muller.
How, one of the battles we might want to watch the second half is Jeff Litton, the center for Muller, and Sean Saturday, the middle guard for Princeton. Both are top athletes. Sean is rated as the top middle guard in the state.
Okay, we're almost ready for the second half kickoff. Remember, the score is Muller 7, Princeton 7, as we enter this third quarter. Steve Fleming approaches the ball, kicks it deep down the area. It's taken by the middle of the field by Rob Brown. Bring it right up the middle. Brown brings it all the way back to the 28-yard line at that point. Just as Coach Jan Nepshield told me before the game, Steve Harvey made that tackle. Number 44, he's the backup linebacker. And of course, went down and made the initial hit and, of course, the tackle on Rob Brown at that point.
Now, some of the first half statistics, first down, Princeton has 5, Muller has 7. Yards rushing, Princeton has 135, Muller has 103. Passing yards, 1 for Princeton, 40 for Muller. Total yards, 136 to 143. Pretty close offensively right in there.
Right. Looks at this point, we have may have a penalty right there. The officials are out talking with one of the co-captains, Arnold Franklin, who's a real fine junior inside linebacker and, of course, tight end. Goes both ways for Muller. Looks like we had a clipping penalty at this point. They're taking the ball all the way back to about the 19-yard line. We had a clip by Muller. They're going to take over. It's going to be first down, their own 19. That was Arnold Franklin out there talking over with the officials. Jeff Litton comes out over the ball. Straight T backfield by the Muller Crusaders. Score 7-7 as we begin the third quarter. All right, ball goes all the way, being brought down to the 20-yard line. That point, we had cross action in the backfield. Had a nice game, pick up another 5 yards at that point. That was Mark Brooks carrying the ball right in there. Mueller rotates the slot backs themselves. Tim King and Jeff Klaus bring in the plays. Jeff Litton out over the ball. We have another full house backfield. Logan takes a snap, hands off to Tim King off the right side across action. He's smothered under by a host of Princeton. They stopped him probably for about a one-yard loss. A host of about five or six people in on that play.
Sean Saturday, number 60, is one of the quickest linemen in the state, and he is really in there pretty rapidly on that play.
We see Wilgin. We have a replay. We had Sean Saturday in there. Breaks through, outstanding. No wonder Coach Mancuso. He stepped in the gap, broke two through two blocks, went in to make the initial hit on that play, and then, of course, we went under with a swarm of additional tacklers. We're back at third and five right now. Mueller splits wide receiver to the outside. Hands off back to Brooks. Oh, he had a flag just before the play began. May have had some... At this point, we usually see this type of situation before the play. We probably had somebody moving on the Mueller team just before the snap. Mueller's had several crucial penalties like this during the ball game. I'm sure this is probably due to the intenseness of a game of this type. And of course, with Mueller having a 29-game winning streak online at this point, of course, they're, you know, extremely intent about their assignments. And sometimes, Charlie, you can jump off when you're in this type of mental situation.
These boys are really keyed up for this ball game, and I can see why they're jumping off sides.
All right. Princeton in their standard 5-2-4 defense. Pitch back to Francisco around the left end, sweeping in there. Picks up about 5 yards. Brings the ball down almost to the Princeton 20, of course, but it's not enough for a first down. It's going to be about fourth and about 6 yards, 5 to 6 yards to go for a first down, right in the middle of the field, the 20-yard line. Mueller brings in their punt team.
How those penalties really stop a lot of drives in football. It's really tough to make up that additional yardage.
Yes, Jim Rolfs goes back to punt for Mueller. He's only had to punt one time. Mueller had a much better, about a 37-yard average on their one punt. Remember, he had that very good hang time. There's another punt, another excellent hang time. Ball coming down almost to midfield at that point. Nobody feels the ball. It rolls back and is down by Mueller on the 48-yard line. In that particular kick, we had a 3.5 hang time, which gave that coverage team plenty of time to get down there.
How we talk about how important the hang time was earlier, we could see it demonstrated on that play because there was a whole swarm of Mueller people down there. The ball carrier, if he had caught the ball, wouldn't have had a chance to advance the ball at all.
Right, Mueller setting up their standard 4-4 defense. Pressing over the ball, puts two wide receivers to the right side, come down to the option. They hand the ball off in there to Emery, who picks up about a yard and a half. As a standard option, veer option type play, handed off to, of course, Emery coming back to the inside, and then continued down, Darryl Mitchell continued down with his fake, and of course, he had David Keeling, who's, of course, the star for Princeton that first half with a long touchdown run, coming around to our left side. We have 9 minutes and 22 seconds to go in this ball game with a score of 7-7. Darryl Mitchell bringing his team out, two wide receivers to the right, quick snap again, hands back in there to Keeling, which hits back over the middle. All right, Charlie, that's what we noticed about earlier in the game. When Keeling kept the ball straight up the middle, he's only picked up a couple of yards. Those plays when he's bounced to the outside, he's had the big gainers.
And a few of those plays, Hal, he hasn't had a chance to block down because that Mueller linebackers are swarmed in there, and he hasn't had a chance to cut. But you're right, when he does break to the outside, that's when he's gotten his big yardage.
All right, it's going third and five now with the ball just past midfield. It's on about the Mueller 47-yard line. Third and five at this point. Two wide receivers to the left. Jeff Raines is one of the backs that's over here. As Darryl Mitchell keeps it, cuts up to the middle, but he only picks up about a yard. We're going to have about a fourth and four at the Mueller 44-yard line. Looks like another punt formation in here. Paul Palumbo does the punting. Unfortunately for the Princeton team, the last time they were in here, Tim Canada snapped the ball over Paul's head. And, of course, Mueller had good field position at that point.
How both defensive lines are using a lot of games in there. There's a lining up in one position and then stunning to another position, which causes a lot of problems on the offensive blocking patterns.
Good snap at this point. There goes Paul. He's trying to get the ball down to the left side in there. Rob Brown signaling for a fair catch. Takes the ball on about the 16, 17-yard line. At this point in this game, brought to you by Warner Amex Cable Television, we have 7 minutes and 59 seconds to go in the third quarter, and the score is Mueller 7, Princeton 7.
Now that Princeton defense has been tough all year long. They've given up an average of only 6.8 points per game. I think that's fantastic.
It certainly is. It just shows the fine players that they have, and of course coordinate on that defense by Ted Bacigalupo. All right, there we go. Brooks keeps the ball again, picks up about 8 yards, and working up the middle. That Brooks is tough. I can see why college scouts, Charlie, are so intent on trying to sign him for their program in the future.
They're all going to be camping on his doorsteps, Hal. He's a very elusive back. He's big. He's got power. He catches the ball, and he can really run. He's gained the most yardage of any running back in Moeller history. He broke the individual game rushing record. He ran for 254 yards in one game. The previous record was 218 yards.
Moeller out over the ball again on first and 10. Full house backfield. Wilgan goes back, hands off in there to Jeff Klaus, who breaks up the middle, hits to the outside. Tackle down there by Farley on the right side. Looks like it might be another first down for Moeller, though. Picked up about, looks like about 11, 12 yards over there. Ball is going out on the 35-yard line. There goes Mike Wilgie. He's going to take the snap from Jeff Litton right there. You can see that fine blocking Lance Lohr on the left side. Breaks off Jeff Klaus, breaks to the outside. He's a real fine junior flanker back. They bring him in the backfield at full house. Here comes the ball. They give it back to Mark Brooks. He cuts back the inside. Several people to bring him down, but Brooks still picks up 3 or 4 yards. Brings the ball down to midfield. It's just shy of the 40-yard line. It's about the 39-yard line. It's going to be second and about long 5 yards to go for the first down. 6 minutes and 54 seconds to go in this ball game. The score is Moeller 7, Princeton 7.
Brooks is now well over 1,000 yards for the season, Hal.
They come out. Moeller lines up immediately in a wide slot to their right. I formation. Jeff Litton hands back, the quick pitch back to Francisco off the left side, cuts back to the inside, picks up several yards. It's going to be about a 3rd and 2 yards to go for the first down. The ball is almost directly between the 40 to 45 yard line. Looks like official is going to place it about the 44 yard line of Moeller. Looks like it's going to be 3rd and about 1 yard to go. 3rd and 1 right at that point on the 44 yard line. Princeton's line. They're coming out. Moeller's coming out in their full house backfield. Princeton's lining up, and they're 5-2. And, of course, they're putting Saturday over in the gap. 5-2-4 by Keehan. Here comes Brooks off the right side. Both the other backs fake to the Moeller left side. Brooks carried again for another first down. I don't think they've stopped him without gaining at least 2 to 3 yards any time tonight, have they, Charlie?
No, he's the guy that they feature all the time, Hal, and he's going to get yardage for him.
No question about it. Remember earlier, about towards the end of the first quarter, they had a little reverse play in there, but most of the time they're handing that ball to Brooks. He's the key to where the ball's going. I'm sure that Princeton defense is following him. Hands off again in there to Francisco. Brooks fakes off the right side along with the other back. Hand back to Francisco. That cross-buck type action goes up, picks up about a yard. Brings the ball up to about the 46-yard line, 47-yard line of Moeller.
Hal, that was a good demonstration of the stinging power of that Princeton defense. They swarm all over the ball carriers. They're hard to fool.
They certainly are. I'm extremely impressed with this offensive line of Moeller. They're big and strong. He's certainly moving back there, enabling the backs. Here goes Wilgan back again. Throws just a little short in the flat. Balls hits the dirt, hits the ground over there just before receiver can catch the ball. Wilgan's a good faker. He's got a real quick, good. I'm very impressed for a junior be playing for Moeller like this. He almost looks like a senior with his experience, his footwork. Very impressive young man, isn't he?
And he's got a real good release on the ball, Hal. He sees his receiver. He finds a secondary receiver. He's not afraid to stand in there and throw that football.
All right, it's 3rd and 9 at this point with the ball at the Moeller 47-yard line. There are 5 minutes to go in the third quarter. The score is Moeller 7, Princeton 7. Moeller puts the 3 wide receivers out here. There goes Wilgan giving the ball to Brooks, pounding off the left side again. He's trying to run right behind the blocking of Jeff Cooper and Lance Lohr. Takes the ball down, crosses midfield into about the 47-yard line. At that point, Moeller's bringing in their kicking units. Jim Rolfe comes back for only his 3rd punt of the ball game. Arnold Franklin getting the signals from the defense, flashing him back to his team. Jim Rolfe's deep. Moeller has a little different punt formation. They put 3 big people in the backfield. There goes Rolfe's. Nice punt. Another little short this time, but he has good hang time. Went off the side of his foot. Gets a good roll again. Moeller, people are around it. Again, he had about a 4.0 hang time on that. Didn't go great distance, but then, of course, from the position in the middle of the field, he didn't have to have very good distance on that kick, did he?
No, and he's done a good job of punting all year. Al, he's got a 38.4 average, which is, I think, a very fine average.
All right, brings up a point with 4 minutes and 26 seconds to go with Princeton taking over. Score, Muller 7, Princeton 7. Princeton on their own 26-yard line. Another quick count again. Hands back in the middle. There goes David Keeling breaking through the middle of the line. He's off on another long run. It goes. Looks like he's going to go all the way. He scores again. David Keeling has just scored another long run again. He just went from their own 25-yard line. Fantastic run. Oh, he ripped off. Just unbelievable. This young man has got fantastic speed.
Now, he's one of the top running backs in the state. He's got great speed. He knows how to use it when he gets out into the open. He now has 14 touchdowns on the season, and seven of them have been for over 40 yards. Tremendous running ability, tremendous speed.
Yes, we certainly hope you're enjoying this game brought to you by Warner Amex Cable Television. The score at this point, we've got Princeton 13, Muller 7. Princeton is lining up to go for the extra point. High up the field goal. Here comes the extra point position. Oh, they fumble the ball. They drop him. At that point, we had a fumbled snap in there. Could be very critical at this point. The score is now Princeton 13, Muller 7. Princeton wanted to kick that extra point.
As you say, Hal, that is critical when you don't make that extra point. Now another touchdown in a field, and the extra point could lick them.
Right. Here goes the play again. Darryl Mitchell back onto the ball. Reverse pivots out. Hands to David Keeling straight ahead. Runs breaks up there. Another key block coming down by the wide receiver coming back across the middle.
Once he gets this far, Hal, nobody's going to catch him. He's going to turn on that tremendous 4-5 speed, and he's off to the races.
The thing that's really impressed me on that play, I saw a key block with Ron Durrett coming from the wide receiver position across the field and setting up the block at that point.
This is a well-coached football team. They play well together. They block for each other. Tremendous attitude, tremendous spirit.
Princeton getting ready to kick off again. Steve Fleming kicking off.
Hal, they're kicking from the hash mark now, trying to keep the ball in one section of the field so the Muller can't get a good return.
Ball goes down to Rob Brown again. Here comes a wedge right up the middle. Oh, a good play. Rob Brown brings the ball up to the 30-yard line there.
This is one of the most exciting games I've seen all season, Hal, and I've seen a lot of games, college and pro.
Score at this point is Princeton 13, Muller 7. Princeton has an 18-game winning streak. Muller has a 29-game winning streak. High formation, hands off to Brooks, bangs off the left side. Stopping him in there. Picks up about 2 to 3 yards. We're going to have second and 7. Charlie, I hope I was giving credit to the right man last time. I think that might have been Michael Lindsay who went across and threw that key block, the split end, who threw the key block to spring David Keeler on that right run, just the way Robbie Leach sprang Keeling that first time on the run. Here we go, another reverse pivot, straight ahead handoff. Muller showing their power, bringing it up. It's going to be about third and two right now with the ball just about on the 39-yard line. He handed off to Hiawatha Francisco, the good sophomore halfback at that point. It's going to be third and one, a big critical play at this point.
Now, both teams have been exceptionally strong in the second half in scoring.
Score at this point is Princeton 13, Muller 7. There are 2 minutes and 52 seconds to go in the third quarter. Muller comes out, wing to their right, eye formation. Good chance, give it to, there goes Francisco up there. Dances just a little bit, but looks like he might have gotten the first down. If he did, it was just barely. Officials are calling timeout, so we get a measurement on this.
He ran behind Brooks on that play, Hal. Brooks is a real fine lead blocker on short yardage.
Does a good job. Yes, he got the first down, Francisco did. Brooks is just an excellent all-around player. Like you say, Charlie, he's not only a fine runner and leader, and an outstanding ground gainer, but he blocks well. He's just a real exceptionally fine athlete. Jeff Litton over the ball for Mueller. They have a wing left, eye backfield. Mike Wilging takes the ball, pitches back to Francisco, running wide to the left. Goes several people. Looks like he picked up a couple yards, though. Outstanding pursuit by that Princeton team that time. Looked like Francisco was going to clear it to the wide to the left side of the field, but the Princeton defense was over there to get him.
Well, Pat told me before the game, one of the key points in this game and winning was that they were going to have to gang tackle to find Mueller backs, and that's what they're trying to do. They're trying to get a lot of people around the ball carriers.
Princeton setting up their 5-2 defense. Mueller over the ball, Jeff Litton, Mike Wilging, the quarterback. Takes the ball, hands off to Mark Brooks, straight up the middle, met by a host of Princeton tacklers right there, but Brooks goes down, picks up about 3 or 4 more yards. Looks like we're going to have another 3rd and 2, almost midfield. Ball's on the Mueller 49-yard line. We're almost here at the end of the third quarter. There's only 1:35. With a score at this point, Princeton 13, Mueller 7.
That was a fine tackle that time, again, by number 60, Sean Saturday. He's a hard man to handle.
3rd and 1.5 right here. 2 wide receivers out to the left side. Mueller's probably going to hand that ball to Brooks again. Here he comes off the right side. Looks like he's got the first down. Taking a pass midfield over to about the Princeton 47-yard line. Ball's in the middle of the field. Fisher's called timeout. Get the chains set up. 1st and 10 at that point. Mueller taking over the ball. 1:10 remaining in this third quarter. With the score, Princeton 13, Mueller 7. 1st and 10. Mueller goes slot formation to the left side. Hands ball back to Francisco. Had Brooks breaking off the left side, faking the action, running behind Lance Lohr and Jeff Cooper on the left side. But Wilging handed back to Hiawatha Francisco, sophomore tailback, who was running behind Tim Odom and Doug Williams.
They hand the ball so much to Brooks, Hal, that when they have a fake to Brooks and handle another back, they have a chance to have a good gainer.
Right. Litton over the ball. Mueller setting their slot formation. High backfield to the left side. Hands off to Brooks. Brooks cut in behind the slant. Broke through. That time I noticed that the entire Princeton defensive line was slanting to the wide side of the field, and Brooks seemed to break in behind them. There's a play right here. As we notice, we can see the Sean Saturday breaking to the wide side of the field. Brooks breaks right in behind the slanting defensive line. Breaks. We had some good blocks, of course, cutoff blocks by Tim Odom, Doug Williams. We're back. It's getting first down. Hands off to Brooks. Same play. This time he's smothered by a host of Princeton tacklers for a loss. It's probably one, I think, about the first loss that they've had on Brooks. Looks like it's going to be about 2nd and about 11 to go. At this point, and that comes the end of this third quarter of this game, brought to you by Warner Animex Cable Television. With the score at this point, Princeton 13, Mueller 7.
Well, that Mueller offensive line is doing a tremendous job of opening holes for their ball carriers in there. Lance Lohr, Doug Williams, Tim Odom, and Jeff Cooper, Jeff Litton, all doing a fine job of straight ahead blocking, sustaining their blocks, and giving the ball carrier something to cut off of.
We enter, yes, I was especially impressed with the way they, after Brooks picked up that big first down, how the Princeton defense came back. They had the entire defensive line, Reggie Dillingham, Walter Mitchell, Sean Satty, Ellery Jett, Reggie Schooler, all in on that, backed up, of course, by those fine linebackers, Arnold Franklin, Ken Lawson on that last play. Princeton came really and put about 7 people on Brooks, and, you know, that's about how many people it takes to bring that big young man down.
That's like a tank coming through the line. He's hard to stop.
Almost ready to begin this fourth quarter. At this point, we have the ball right now on the Princeton 31-yard line. We've got 2nd and 11 to go. Princeton leading 13-7 as we begin the fourth quarter. First play. Hands the ball back. Here comes Klaus running on a wing back reverse in there. Picks up another nice gain. Something about 5 yards in that point. Running out of bounds over there. Mueller showing their power. They're trying to grind it out and take it back in. Brings the ball back to 2nd and 5. Here's Tim King bringing in the play from Coach Jerry Faust. Jeff Litton out of the huddle. Comes the Mueller offensive line. Tim King comes out in the slot to the right side. High formation. Princeton in their usual five-man line. Hands off to Brooks. Brooks hanging off the left side. Carries it down for two or three more yards. We're going to have about a third. All very, very close to the first down at this point. We certainly hope you are enjoying this game brought to you by Warner Amex Cable Television. There are 11 minutes and 48 seconds to go in this game with Princeton leading 13-7. We've got a couple long win streaks on the line tonight, don't we, Charlie?
Certainly do. Muller's trying to control the game right now with a sustained ground drive, and her offensive line is doing a real good job of blocking for the ball carrier.
Got first and 10 at this point. 11 minutes, 37 seconds to go from the Princeton 20-yard line. I formation, hands off to Francisco right up the middle, picks up another 4 to 5 yards. Riding straight behind Jeff Litton. Of course, Jeff Cooper at left guard position, Tim Odom at the right guard position. Just driving with Brooks leading the way. Tim King bringing in another play from Coach Faust. It's 2nd and 5. Arnold Franklin calling the defenses for the Princeton Vikings. It's 2nd and 5 right now with the ball in the Princeton 25. Princeton's in their 5-2 alignment. Hands the ball back. Here comes the reverse again. It comes up there. It's tremendous speed by Sean Saturday. As he gets
Sean
over there,
Saturday's a tremendous football player.
Takes the ball down now. We've got about 3rd and 3 to 4 yards to go. The ball looks like it's about on the 13-yard line right now on the left hash. Short side of the field will be to Muller's left, and of course the Princeton defense is right. Arnold Franklin getting ready to take the signals from the sideline of Princeton. Jeff Litton coming out. Jeff Klaus just came in with the play. Got two tight end offense. Klaus out wide. High formation, gives it off Brooks off the left side. Picks up almost down to the first down. Play crossed past the 10-yard line to about the 8. Should be about a first down at this point for the Muller Crusaders as they're trying to go ahead in this ball game. They're trailing right now by 6 points. Princeton has 13, Muller 7.
George, are you enjoying the ball game? We have George Foster here with us in the booth tonight.
It's a very tight ball game. We have a good crowd out here tonight, and it's a hard-fought game, and they're battling all the way. And I know that both teams are out there going out there trying to be the best team tonight.
Well, George, it's a real pleasure to have you with us tonight. We're glad you're enjoying the game because this is a top-rated football game.
Well, I heard a lot about Muller's football team, and I heard some about Princeton. I know it's going to be a good ball game even before I had, you know, come here, but I know it's going to, people out here are very excited watching this particular game, and everything that really happened, it excites them.
Well, George, it's a real pleasure having you with us. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you, George. We're back right now. 10 minutes and 21 seconds to go in this ball game. Princeton is ahead 13-7. We have first down, the ball just to pass the 10-yard line. Straight T backfield by the Muller Crusaders. Wilgen getting ready to take the snaps. Hands back to Tim King, straight up the middle. He powers his way down, crossing past the 5-yard line to about the 3-yard line. Tremendous upfront blocking by that offensive line. Jeff Litton, Jeff Cooper, Tim Odom, Doug Williams, and Lance Lohr all opening the way up there.
They're doing a good job of controlling the ball right now, Al. This is what their plan was in the second half, not to give up that football. They had 4 turnovers in the first half that really stopped their drives.
That's correct. And they've played flawless ball in this half. They've got 2 tight ends at this point, full house backfield. Princeton is in their goal line defense, a 6-5 defense. Pitches the ball back to Klaus, running wide on the side, cuts up, takes it down almost about the 1-yard line. Cut back to the inside, did a fine job. We're going to have 3rd and about 1 right now. Big plays coming up at this point. 3rd and 1. Princeton's running their defensive team in a play ago. They've got their goal line defense. Tim King bringing in the goal, bringing this play from Coach Jerry Faust's offensive staff. Jeff Litton over the ball. Muller lining up again. They're straight T backfield. They're 9 minutes and 2 seconds to go, and they're trying to tie this game up. There goes. He hands it off to Brooks, who carries it in. Mark Brooks just carried the ball in. They had the fake wide action just like they did a minute ago and gave it to their bread and butter man, Mark Brooks.
Al, right now it looks like that extra point could loom as a very big play.
That's right. Tony Malink is an excellent extra point kicker. And of course the score is now tied with 8 minutes and 55 seconds to go in the fourth quarter. The score is Princeton 13, Muller 13. Muller is now lining up, going for the extra point.
Malink has kicked 25 extra points this year, 6 field goals for 43 points.
Oh, he had somebody jumping offside early in there for Princeton. We had Tim Canada firing across the line at that point, jumping the count just a little bit early. We're going to have a penalty. He's against the Princeton team.
He's really fired up because he knows how important it would be if he could block this extra point.
This is a key play, of course. Every play is becoming more and more important in this ball game with the score 13-13, 8 minutes and 55 seconds to go. Malink lining up the play. Big play now for Muller at this. John Katerba is the one who centers the ball in the snaps. He replaces Jeff Litton on the extra point kicks. Here goes the ball up. It's up and it's good. Muller takes the lead, 14-13. They just kicked the extra point this time. Just an outstanding drive in that last series, Charlie.
That was a real fine drive, how they not only controlled the football, but they controlled the clock. They used up quite a bit of drive on, quite a bit of time on that last drive. Their offensive line did a real fine job of opening up the holes for the ball carrier. Of course, the big ball carrier was Brooks, but they alternated the other backs by faking the Brooks and handing off to the other backs in there. And all of the Muller backs, Jeff Klaus, Tim King, they're all fine ball carriers.
Yes, Muller did a good job, I thought, in his third quarter in comparison to the first half. They began running more action, faking Brooks one way and bringing their slot backs, Jeff Klaus and Tim King, back to the opposite side. Did a good job crossing their backfield action.
How in the first half they lost the football four times, two times on interceptions and two times on fumbles. And you just can't do that. When you have a drive going, you give up the football, it just gives the other team the opportunity and it stops your opportunity.
Tony Malink lining up for Muller right now at this point. Hope you're enjoying this game brought to you by Warner Amex. 8 minutes and 55 seconds to go in the fourth quarter with Muller leading Princeton 14-13. Muller going after their 30th consecutive victory, and of course Princeton trying to preserve their 18 victories going for their 19th. Ball going down to David Gleaves, takes him about the 10, running back up the middle, breaks loose, breaks up in the middle of the field, and brought down just about the 42-yard line. Excellent run by David Gleaves.
Real fine awareness where his blocking was. He kind of paced himself. He saw where the hole was. He had a real fine burst in there and got a real fine return. Gave the Princeton team real good field position.
Right, and I think also very importantly at this point, Princeton needs that little shot in the arm, get their motivation, their momentum back, get a little enthusiasm going for themselves. They were a little bit down after that extra point, naturally, when they went behind by 1 point. Mitchell out, split backfield, comes down the line on his option. Mitchell keeping the ball, turning up to the outside, picking up about a yard. Very hard at that point to gain too much. Muller's very fired up now as they've gone ahead by 1 point, 14-13, here in the middle of the fourth quarter. It's second and nine at this point. Ball in the, with Princeton will have the ball into their short side, will be the left side. Of course, Mike Hartman will be coming out to the wide side. He's their wide side halfback and a two-year starter. There are only two returning starters in this Muller defense. Mike Larkin, their outstanding major college prospect inside linebacker, and Mike Hartman at this wide side halfback. They put him to the open side of the field. There goes Keeling breaking back over the middle again. Another good play, picks up almost the first down.
As you say, Hal, he didn't break to the outside that time. He went straight up the middle, and he didn't have the long run, but that was a real fine play. He's the big play man, there's no question about it. Right. He can break any play for the distance, as he's demonstrated so far in this ballgame with two long touchdown drives.
All right, Cornell Mullen coming at a wide receiver, bringing the play in from Coach Mancuso. Two wide receivers coming out here. Michael Lindsay coming out along with Mullen, wide to the side of the field right here. There goes Mitchell coming back around, handing off again. Almost getting a first down, handing back in there to David Keeling.
Now Bobby Mail, defensive tackle, number 52, has been playing a real fine football game. He's got good pursuit, he's aggressive, and he's real tough to move off the line of scrimmage.
He certainly is. That entire defensive front of Pat Kennedy and Mike Lane, as you mentioned, Bob Mail, Ron Davis, Charles Lima, they're all doing an outstanding job. Of course, they're backed up by two real fine linebackers, Mike Harmeyer and Mike Larkin.
Bobby Mail's brother was a real fine kicker at Notre Dame last year.
All right, there's 7 minutes and 21 seconds. Muller leading in this ball game, 14-13. Larry Farley coming, bringing the play for Princeton right at this point. Just inches to go for a first down. They're having a measurement out there. Inches to go. Larry Farley just brought in the play from Coach Mancuso. At this point, they're certainly going to go for it. Get themselves back in this game as they trail Mueller by 1 point, score of 14-13.
This is where the real estate becomes hard to get, Hal, down in these short yardage situations.
Mueller comes up right now. Wide receiver, the formation to the right side for Princeton. There goes a quarterback sneak by Mitchell. Looks like he just went across just enough to get the first down. Probably picked up about half a yard on that play, but that's all Princeton needed at this point.
Now, that's the safest play they could have used at that time. There's no exchange problems there. They just needed a couple of inches straight ahead by the quarterback. That's the most intelligent play they could have used.
This is an outstanding game at this point. It's first down. There's 7 minutes and 2 seconds to go in the fourth quarter, and Princeton is driving. David Gleaves, of course, with that outstanding kickoff return after that Mueller touchdown, put them in this position. Now they're moving the ball back. There goes Mitchell back, throwing a long pass. He overthrows it again. Just overthrew the receivers back there. He's trying to throw the ball down to Cornell Mullen, who is breaking up the left side.
He threw the football too much on the line, Hal. He didn't give the receiver a chance to run under the football. On a long pass like that, you've got to loft the ball in the air so the receiver has a chance to adjust to it. If you throw the ball on the line, it's a one-shot opportunity. It has to be right there or it's not going to be completed. Where you put the ball high in the air, a receiver has a chance to adjust and catch the football.
All right, we've got second and 10 at this point. Score Mueller 14, Princeton 13. They put two wide receivers out to the right side. They're being covered by Mike Hartman and Jeff Raines. Here comes Mitchell, keeps the ball in the reverse, cuts it back up the inside, tremendous speed. Runs the ball for a first down, takes the ball down to the Mueller 32-yard line.
Wow, he almost broke out into the open on that one. He showed real fine running ability on that particular play.
Okay, Darryl Mitchell under the ball, takes the ball, reverse pivot in. Comes down, he's run the option, sees everything covered to the outside, cuts back to the inside. That's his finest run of the night. Breaking in, almost thought he's going to break it all the way. At that point, Randy Barger is one of the people making the tackle. All right, back again, throwing for a loss at this point. We're now going to have, we're going to end up having a second. We're thrown back, we're going to have a second down situation right now. There are only 6 minutes and 14 seconds to go in this outstanding game. Second, about 9.5 to go. Len Farley bringing in the play from Coach Mancuso. Mueller leads 14-13.
The thing Princeton's got to be aware of on this drive is to at least get the ball in position for a field goal, Hal.
That's correct. There goes Mitchell coming back, comes to the option, cuts back to the inside, but he stopped in there for only about a yard gain. We're going to bring up a situation of about 3rd and 7 at this time. It's only 5 minutes and 43 seconds to go with Mueller leading 14-13.
That was a repeat of the last play that he ran, Hal, where he had such a successful gain. On this one, he didn't make quite as much.
Princeton coming out of the formation, put two wide receivers to the right. Mueller countering that, bringing their two defensive backs over this way. There goes Mitchell out to the left side, away from those two wide receivers. Keeps the ball, takes down for a 3 or 4 yard game. Of course, it's going to be short. At this point, we're going to have probably about a fourth down, about 3 yards to go for the first down at this point. The ball is on the Mueller 26-yard line. There are only 5 minutes to go in the game with Mueller leading 14-13. Princeton has called timeout. They want to talk this over. Coach Mancuso, of course, is still on the sidelines. He's not going to talk with the team yet. He's relaying his messages by Len Farley. They're talking over with his assistant coaches in the stands. They're up here.
This is a big situation right here, Hal. If they can keep possession of this football and get down there and at least get a field goal, this is what they need right now, because missing that extra point early in the ball game is looming to be a bigger and bigger play right now.
It certainly is. After consulting with his assistant coaches in the press box, Coach Mancuso has entered the huddle to discuss this very critical play at this point. We have a 4th down and 3. There are only 5 minutes to go in the game. And of course, Mueller has a good defensive group in there. They're playing outstanding game all night. We've just had those two long runs by David Keeling and broken the back of the Mueller defense.
This is Carl Sagan. Come with me on a voyage of discovery across space and time. Humans have always been explorers. We've built ships to sail the oceans of Earth, and now to sail the seas of space. We are the explorers of a dozen new worlds. Join me in the adventure of cosmos.
Take this voyage Sunday night at 8 o'clock. It's Cosmos.
Masterpiece Theater presents Jane Austen's Pride and Prejudice. This week, the Bennets receive a guest and a surprise.
To make some atonement for inheriting their father's estate, I mean to choose one of your daughters in marriage, Mrs. Bennet.
Be sure to watch Pride and Prejudice this week on Masterpiece Theater.
Watch it on TV 48. This is WCET, Channel 48, Cincinnati.
Watch it, TV 48.
Mitchell keeping the ball, drives. I don't think he made it, though. It's almost up. They're going to have a measurement on this. He may have made it or may not. It's going to be very, very close. Ball's going to be in the middle of field. Start with the option. Turn it up. It's going to be awfully close.
A lot of determination on that. He was sure trying to stretch that ball over that mark to get the first down, Hal. Princeton's record under Pat Mancuso is 161 wins, 36 losses, and 11 ties. That's a tremendous record. One of the best in high school history.
Looks like Princeton made it. Excellent keeper by Darryl Mitchell at that point. Turned it right up the middle. It's first down for the Princeton Vikings on the Muller 23-yard line. We've got less than 5 minutes to go in this ball game. 4 minutes and 52 seconds to go. Muller leading 14-13. Mullen bringing the play from Coach Mancuso. Wide side of the field is to the defense's left side. Princeton puts the two wide receivers in the short side of the field. They come down, hand off in there to Keeling. He stopped almost the line of scrimmage. Excellent play again in there by Bob Mayo, Mike Lane, and left side of that defensive line.
Moeller's really been keying on Keeling this half. They don't want to let him break like he did in the first half. They're trying to stop him.
Larry Farley coming in with this second and 10 play right now. We've got just a little over 4 minutes to go in this game. Muller leading 14-13. Ball in the middle of the field on the Muller 23-yard line. Muller puts their Jeff Raines, Mike Hartman out to the wide side of the field. The two receivers, here comes Mitchell. Pitches the ball back. It's a wide pitch to Emery. He recovers the ball. Very critical play. Looks like he fumbled it again, and Muller is recovered on the Muller 41-yard line. Muller has recovered again. Emery fumbled the ball, recovered it, and then fumbled it again.
Hal, that's the danger of those option plays. They're tremendous plays and tough to defense. It's an opportunity to give up the football.
Yeah, he fakes, of course, the dive play, pitches it back to Emery, who just misses the ball. Looks like he's going to fall on it. Falls on it, and then the ball fumbles away from him again. Muller recovers in there. It's a very big play for Muller taking over on the 1 yard line. That's Steve Betts recovering that ball. Okay, we've got only about a 1 yard gain right now. 14-13, very critical play at this point. They're gonna have to have a big play. Francisco carry the ball that last play. Princeton's gonna have to have a big play to get back in this ball game. They're gonna be down just a little bit emotionally after losing that ball. And of course, there are only 3 minutes and 18 seconds to go. And Muller's gonna try to grind it out just as they did on that last drive. They put Jeff Klaus out to the wide side of the field, eye backfield. Muller in their 5-2 defense with Sean Saturday sitting offside, sitting in the offside center guard gap. They hand off to Brooks straight up the middle, who piles for another 2 to 3 yards.
Hal, Princeton's going to have to gamble a little bit on defense to force a fumble.
Very important penalty at that point for Princeton. The ball is going to go against Muller. Of course, very importantly, it stops the clock with only 3 minutes and 4 seconds to go, with Muller leading by 1 point. Takes the ball back to the 39-yard line. We're going to have a second and 11 and a half to go from the Muller 39-yard line. Muller, of course, has got to control the ball. They've got to use up the clock. They've got to get a first down at this point. No question about it. They've got to have the first down. Klaus splits out wide.
Here goes Wilging, hands off the Brooks strip, giving it to him. He drives, takes the ball up for about a 6-yard gain. It's going to put the ball now at about third and five and a half to go for the first down. The ball is on the Muller 45-yard line, the short side of the field to their left. Princeton lining up, Arnold Franklin, a real fine inside linebacker. Linebacker's getting the signals, the sidelines. Muller comes out again, eye backfield. With a wide receiver to the right, two tight ends, hands off to Brooks on the right side, goes again, looks like he's got the first down. He drives in there on his own. He had a tremendous forward body lean by Mark Brooks, and he carries that ball, Charlie. His forward lean is so impressive.
Now, at this stage of the game, they're not going to take any chances. They're going to do what they do best, and that's give the ball to Brooks, straight ahead blocking. As you say, he's got tremendous balance, good lean. He's going to get the most out of the play. Then they're going to come back and fake to Brooks and give the ball to one of those other ball carriers.
All right, 2 minutes and 15 seconds to go with Muller leading 14-13. The ball on the Princeton 49-yard line. Slot to the right. Hands off to Brooks again, who drives in there for 2 to 3 more yards before he's tackled at that point. We have only 2 minutes and 4 seconds to go at this point. Time is becoming so critical. Muller has got to pick up another first down. Of course, the Princeton defense wants to stop him at this point.
Princeton's going to have to do something to try to cause a fumble here, Hal. They're going to have to gamble a little bit, maybe do get a couple of blitzes going in there so they can get to the ball carrier early.
Here goes eye backfield again. Hands off to Brooks again, right up the middle. Swarmed under. Excellent by up front line play. And, of course, the two linebackers for Princeton doing a good job stopping him in there. Arnold Franklin, Ken Lawson, who are coached, of course, by Larry Cox. They've been doing an outstanding job all night. Princeton calls timeout. There's only 1 minute and 28 seconds to go in this ball game. Coach Mancuso going onto the field to discuss things with the team. Princeton, of course, has got to get this ball on a third and five situation. They cannot let Muller get another first down.
Muller gets another first down. He'll just run it out, Hal, because they've been doing a real good job of picking up 4 and 5 yards at a clip with giving the ball to big Mark Brooks. Mark Brooks is one of the finest college high school fullbacks that I've seen in a good many years. You can bet that he's going to have his choice of what schools he would like to go to. And I understand he's a real fine student.
At this point, we have 1 minute when time resumes on this game brought to you by Warner Amex. There are only going to be 1 minute and 28 seconds to go with Muller leading 14-13. The ball is on the Princeton 44-yard line. It's third and a long five to go. Muller puts a wing out to the left. They hand the ball back. Here comes the reverse. Hands off to Klaus in there. He breaks. He's got the first down. Goes out of bounds. The only good thing happened on that play for Princeton's benefit that the ball carry did go out of bounds, but it's a first down as they control the ball at this point.
Now, Klaus is a real fine ball carrier. He's had a real fine year so far. He's gained 257 yards.
Yes, here they come. They fake the ball off to Francisco. All right, they hand the ball back. There goes Klaus running out. He's led very well around that right side by Jeff Cooper, the left guard who pulled on that play. Had good action. Here we go again, full house backfield. Hands the ball to Tim King, driving hard off that right side behind the big right tackle, Doug Williams, and, of course, the right guard, Tim Odom, who've been opening holes all night for the Muller Crusaders. We only have 1 minute and 9 seconds to go in this game, with Muller leading 14-13. Muller has that 29-game win streak, and, of course, Princeton has an 18-game win streak, with Muller ranked number one in the state and Princeton ranked number two.
These are two outstanding teams, Al. Playing an outstanding ball game tonight.
Straight tee backfield for the Crusaders. Wilging hands the ball to Brooks off the left side, breaks in the clear, takes the ball all the way down. Looks like another first down for Muller, which is just what they needed. There are only 40 seconds to go in the ball game. The ball is now down to the 25-yard line, directly in the middle of the field.
Here comes big Mark Brooks again. The bread and butter ball player, handoff. Good body lean, a real good hole. His own blocker gets in his own way, or he might have broken it all away and scored.
He's finally tackled and brought down by Harold McGuire. What's that whole defensive backfield has done a good job tackling. They're coached by Fran Burns. All right. Plays up there. There are only 17 seconds to go. 16, 15, 14. Not much time remaining. Muller's ahead 14-13. They're 10 seconds. Looks like it's almost over. 9 seconds, 7, 6. This game's history, folks. We hope you've enjoyed tonight's game between the Princeton Vikings and the Muller Crusaders, where the final once again was Muller 14, Princeton 13.
Here's what's coming up tonight on TV 48. At 7, see the finals competition in men's world fast pitch softball, when speed is the name of the game and winning and losing depends on the astonishing power, skill, and control of the pitchers. Tonight at 8, Cosmos cruises among the planets. Cosmos with Dr. Carl Sagan. At 9:30 tonight, Masterpiece Theater presents the second episode of Jane Austen's Pride and Prejudice. At 10, enjoy Evening at Symphony on TV 48 and WGUC, 90.9 FM. Seiji Ozawa conducts the Boston Symphony Orchestra. Don't miss soccer competition tonight at 11 o'clock. Watch it all on TV 48.
TV 48 brings you Evening at Symphony, All Creatures Great and Small, Nova, Jazz at Snowbird, The Body in Question, Masterpiece Theater, and Soundstage. This is WCET, TV 48, Cincinnati, Ohio.
Watch it, TV 48!
We now join our regularly scheduled program, In Progress.